Shalom. I want to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rekak Wadash. All blessings, honor, glory, and power be unto the Heavenly Father, whose name is Yahweh, and His only begotten Son, our Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles and the elder bishops of Great Millstone, who taught me this truth. And salutations to the elect scattered abroad throughout the four corners of the earth. My name is Amawan Gabar. Back with another lesson, Lord willing, to edify and to feed the lambs of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai through the Holy Spirit. Rakat Kodash, Lord willing, this is edifying, straight to the point. And this is a video that Brothers has sent in the chat. And this actual website from the NYC New York City Emergency Management. And you have this woman right here. She's giving a quick instructional or tutorial on what to do in a preparedness or in a situation of a nuclear attack. All right, now there's nothing you could do in the case of a nuclear attack. All right, the only thing that can be done to survive a nuclear attack is the Lord will have to deliver you. All right, or the Lord will have to deliver us, because this is going to face the whole entire Babylon. This is a reality that's soon to come. All right, this is a reality that's soon to come, real soon. Okay, hence, you know, the wars and the rumors of wars, nations against nations, kingdom against kingdom, like the Lord prophesied. And then you have more of this. You have this nuclear preparedness PSA, public service announcement with captions. And this is from the YouTube NYC Emergency Management. I'm sure if I was to Google it, it would be more information on it. But I'm going to play this video real quick.
So there's been a nuclear attack. Don't ask me how or why. Just know that the big one has hit. Okay? So what do we do? There are three important steps that I want you to remember. Step one, get inside fast. You, your friends, your family, get inside. And no, staying in the car is not an option. You need to get into a building and move away from the windows. Step two, stay inside. Shut all doors and windows. Have a basement? Head there. If you don't have one, get as far into the middle of the building as possible. If you were outside after the blast, get clean immediately. Remove and bag all outer clothing to keep radioactive dust or ash away from your body. Step three, stay tuned. Follow media for more information. Don't forget to sign up for Notify NYC for official alerts and updates. And don't go outside until officials say it's safe. All right, you've got this.
And she forgot the most important step. Step four, if you're part of the two-thirds or the heathen nations, Esau and the heathen nations, then just be prepared to burn. You know, I mean, because we got the instructions, we got the steps. She's not going to give the steps. You know, Eve ain't going to get the steps, but we've been given the steps through the Holy Spirit sent down from Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, from the apostles of Great Millstone, the elder bishops, elder brothers, teachers, prophets, so on and so forth. But the instructions, we were preparing ourselves for this day to come, you know. For this day, this is the terrible day of the Lord, like the scriptures say. All right, that's it. I mean, you know, this just goes to show that we are in that time. We are in that time. You know, and that's mainly what I want to just, you know, speak on briefly. We are in that time. That's why they're putting out PSA, public service announcements, on what to do in the case of a nuclear attack. Well, once the missiles hit, that's it. The scriptures tell you that the elements shall melt with fervent heat. And it also say in the book of Revelation that in 1 hour shall that great city Babylon be thrown down. All right. 1 hour, America is going to be destroyed, because once them nukes start flying, it's over. It's a wrap. Once that first nuke is flying, it's a wrap, man. So I'm just going to bring out the scripture real quick. A little willing, quick edifying, straight to the point. It's the book of Zephaniah chapter 1 and verse 14. The great day of the Lord is near, it is near, and hasteth greatly, even the voice of the day of the Lord. The mighty men shall cry there bitterly. That day is a day of wrath, a day of trouble and distress, a day of wasteness and desolation, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness. That's the great day of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai, when the Lord sends Yahweh Shai to come and destroy this place. It is near, it is near, it's very near. All right? And like we always bring out, the most important step, one of the most important things or prophecy to happen before the great day of the Lord, before the great day of Yahweh Shai, before he comes and destroys this place, will have to be the implementation, the mandating of the MOTB. All right, which stands for the mark of the BEAST. All right, written in Revelation, the 13th chapter, verse 16, which we've been teaching from the apostles on down. All right, which is going to be the siragma, when they're going to put it up under your skin. All right, hand or forehead. So that got to happen, and it is going to happen. All right, we are living in a time of famine, plagues, pestilence. That's obvious now. Even the average Joe Schmo know that. Okay, so again, the great day of the Lord is near. It is near, and hasteth greatly, even the voice of the day of the Lord. Because before the Lord come, what is he gonna do? Or before the Lord come, what does he do? Jeremiah 28 tells you that before the prophets that have been before me prophesy against many kingdom and countries, you know, of wars and pestilence and so on and so forth. All right, so the Lord will always send out his prophets before he does something. All right, and the time is coming where the prophets are not going to be on the scene anymore, or not going to be in the main these platforms such as YouTube, you know, which ties into the famine of hearing the word of the Lord, because there's no going to be nobody to comfort these people when they're catching hell. When all hell break loose, the word of the Lord is going to be precious in that time, and only the elect is going to be the ones obtaining it. All right, Isaiah 33:6, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. All right, so the mighty men shall cry there bitterly. All right, all these mighty men, these men of war. Okay, they're gonna cry bitterly. Okay, when the Lord brings his destruction, ain't nobody going to be able to stand up against Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai, the only begotten son and the angels. It says that day is a day of wrath, a day of trouble and distress, a day of wasteness and desolation. Hey, the scriptures say in Isaiah 54, the Lord created the waster to destroy. Okay, the waster is the nukes, the missiles. It's going to waste this place. It's going to be left desolate. There's going to be nothing left here in Babylon. You ain't gonna be able to run in no basement, no under no table. I remember in grade school, they used to have fallout drills. The alarm used to sound. The alarm used to go off like a little nuke siren type of alarm type of thing. Everybody used to hide under the tables and shelter for cover and all this other stuff. That ain't gonna do a damn thing. You know, it's like a placebo type of thing. Matter of fact, I heard that in them airplanes, when they drop them gas masks when the plane's about to crash, I'm not sure how true it is, but I heard it's like a gas or something to like make you feel less panicky, because you're gonna die anyway, you know. So all these, you know, New York State emergency nuclear preparedness, man, listen, man, nobody's gonna be able to stand against the day of the Lord. Nobody. All right. And we hope and pray that we are part of the elect and we receive salvation when his destruction does come. So it says a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness. All right, it's going to be a dark day when Yahweh Shai come back. All right, it's going to be a dark day, meaning the Lord's coming with them chariots, covering the skies. All right, gloomy, it's going to be gloomy. a day of clouds and thick darkness. So it's going to be a dark day when the Lord come back, man. You know, when the missiles is shot, there's going to be a dark cloud over the earth. America is going to be totally wasted. You got to, you know, just imagine New York City and Manhattan when them towers fell down. It was dark. It was smoke. It was gloomy in that state, you know, in that city. How much more when the entire continent is destroyed by thermonuclear destruction? You know, that's why the scriptures say a smoke ascended up into the clouds forever, but which is just a long period of time. It's going to be a long period of time, like it says in Isaiah 26 and 10, that come my people enter into the chambers until the indignation be overpassed. All right? So, again, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness. Again, them chariots, you know, this is going to be a very dark, gloomy day. You know, it says a day of the trumpet and alarm against defensed cities and against the high towers. And I will bring distress upon men, that they shall walk like blind men, because they have sinned against the Lord, and their blood shall be poured out as dust and their flesh as dung. Okay, so a day of the trumpet against the alarm city. Or day of the trumpet and alarm against the fenced cities and against the high towers. You know, hey man, it's gonna be a hell of a day. You know, Revelation 18, the seventh trumpet. I mean, the eighth chapter, the seventh trumpet. It's the trumpet is gonna sound. The Lord's gonna blow that trumpet, or the angel's gonna blow that trumpet. Excuse me. It says, Revelation 8 and 8. Matter of fact, I started 7 or 6. I started verse 6. It says, and the seven angels which had the seven trumpets prepared themselves to sound. The first angel sounded, and they followed hail mingled with fire. Excuse me. It followed hail and fire mingled with blood, and they were cast upon the earth. And the third part of the trees were burnt up. And all the green grass was burnt up. The third part represent what? The third part representing Esau. Okay? The trees represents nations. Okay, when you go back to the book of Genesis, the trees represents the nations. And we know that in the beginning, the earth was divided among, or the people were divided in threes. You had the sons of God, the sons of the wicked, which are the Edomites. The sons of God, of course, the Israelites. The righteous seed. And then you had the sons of the wicked, the Edomites, all right, the wicked seed. And then you had the sons of men, the other nations. So the third part of the trees were burnt up, representing Esau and his kingdom, these Edomites. It says, and all the green grass was burnt up. And the second angel sounded, and as it were a great mountain burning with fire, was cast into the sea. And the third part of the sea became blood. And the third part of the creatures which were in the sea and had life died. And the third part of the ship were destroyed. And the third angel sounded, and there fell a great star from the heaven. This is all talking about the missiles being shot. It says, burning as it were a lamp. And it fell upon the third part of the rivers and upon the fountains of the waters. And the name of the star is called Wormwood. And the third part of the waters became Wormwood. And many men died because they were made bitter. All right, because what's going to happen is that after the missiles, after the nuclear fire, the nukes are shot, the waters are going to become contaminated because of the radiation. And people are going to be dying from drinking that water. All right. So let me go back to the book of Zephaniah, verse 1. It says, now verse 17, 1 and 17. Now bring distress upon men, that they shall walk like blind men, meaning they're going to be in a confused state of mind. All right, people, nobody's going to have no answers. The wisdom of this world is going to be blotted out. Everything you thought you knew, whatever religion you these people followed, whatever ideology, way of thinking, life, whatever, all the answers are going to be gone. People are going to be confused as all hell. Chaos, chaotic. It says, because they have sinned against the Lord, and their blood shall be poured out as dust, and their flesh as dung. Neither the silver nor their gold shall be able to deliver them in the day of the Lord's wrath. But the whole land shall be devoured by the fire of his jealousy, the whole land of America. For he shall make even a speedy riddance of all them that dwell on the land. So this thing is going to move fast. All right, it's going to move fast, man. You know, like I said earlier, the mass implementation of the MOTB, that's next. That's coming. It's coming soon. All right, things are already in place. The towers are up. Smart cities. The dollar's declining. You know, people already getting already gotten accustomed to cryptocurrencies, which mean hidden currencies. You know, currencies you can't see. In other words, computer money. You know what I'm saying? You know, so this place is done. You know, this place is out of here. And you know, this three-step plan right here: get inside, stay tuned. Step four, you gonna burn and die. If you ain't part of the Lord's elect and the Lord don't deliver in that time, then you just ain't gonna make it. You know, Lord willing, we make it that are part of the hopeful elect. So with that, I hope and pray this was edifying to the elect, the nation of Israel. Till next time, I say, Shalom.